My name is Jess, also known as That Video Girl, and I want to help you to take the panic out of creating videos for your social media. And today we are dipping back into YouTube land. We're gonna get this done. We're setting up your channel together, and your channel banner is a big part of that. Now, I do have a step-by-step guide for setting up your YouTube channel. It's on my website, thatvideogirl.com. Feel free to suss it out if you want, but when I'm teaching people how to set up their YouTube channels, when we get to the sort of the graphic design element of it, like your channel art, people freak out. They just totally go, oh my God, I'm not a graphic designer. I don't know what I'm doing, help. So that's what this video is all about. It's also important to know what good channel art is. So keep in mind that good channel art is easily understandable. That means that people can easily read it, that it's really nice and clear, and that people can kind of get a sense of what to expect from the channel just by looking at the banner. This also means that your channel art or your banner, I'm gonna flip-flop between the two, I hope you don't mind. It also needs to be on brand. That means you need to use colors that are maybe part of your branding, use font and text that is part of your branding, use images that are part of your branding. Oh, by the way, if I'm giving you some value here, if you like what you see, let me know. Leave me a comment down below, hit like, hit subscribe, do all that fun stuff, hit the bell, and I'll know that you like what you see. For this particular tutorial, I am not using Canva. You can still use Canva if you want. That's okay, that's up to you. If your Canva is working, please go right ahead and use it. Mine isn't working. Don't know why, so instead I'm using something called Crello. So make sure that you have made an account and you are all logged in. I'm gonna hover over here, I'm gonna click on covers and headers, and in Canva as well, it has this YouTube channel art. When you find YouTube channel art, that's what you want. And you can see there 2560 by 1440 pixels. We're good to go. When it opens up, excuse all the birds in the background there, it's the afternoon. You'll see on the left-hand side a lot of templates and a lot of different designs, and you can use these if you want. But the problem with a lot of them is that they're fairly generic. So I've made a template and I would love you to download that. It's free. I'm gonna put a link for you in the video description. You can download that for free. Then you can upload it to your chosen graphic design account. And then once you've done that, it should be sitting in your uploads folder or your files. You can adjust the size of this template. You just pull the corner, like hold the corner and pull it out. And you do that on both sides. Wow, that bird is like really having a good old afternoon. Okay. And once that's done, I suggest that you lock it. You're not going to end up seeing this template at the end, but because we're working in layers, it means that you're able to move each layer around without disturbing what's underneath. And that's how a lot of graphic design programs work. Quick note about this template here. You will notice that through the middle is all the information. This is the most important bit, VIP area right here in the middle. And the most VIP of the VIP area is the pink area here. It says desktop and mobile. So that pink zone is what's going to be shown no matter what. And especially on mobile, you need to make sure that everything fits into that particular space. Now, the channel that I'm going to be adding to today is called Billy Box Co. And Billy Box Co. sells boxes. Bespoke boxes, apparently. And I found a picture of some cute little plant boxes on the internet here. I dropped that into the little canvas area here, and it's pretty small. It's way too small. It's gonna get lost. So I'm gonna make it big. If I move it around, I can drag it. But then if I click on the corner and I pull that image all the way out, make it nice and big, and then I can move it up a little bit here. Make sure it stays in the canvas area. I think it's okay, but I've lost my bottom layer. I can't see it at the moment. So what I might try and do is change the transparency. Canva has this as well, except it's located up in this corner. It looks like a checkerboard. If you click that and you lower the transparency, and then I can still see my template underneath, and it will help to guide me. What I want to do next is actually say, this is Billy Box Co. So on the left-hand side, you should see something for font or texts, and it will give you a lot of options that you can use if you want. But I'm just going to click add heading text, and I'm going to say what this channel is called. It's called Billy Box Co. Remember, you want to stay on brand. So if you have a particular font for your brand, then make sure you know what it is and use it. It's really important to be consistent. Remember, we need to make sure that this is easy to see on a small screen as well. You can change the font size as well. So right now it's on 24 point, which is pretty chunky. See, 22. I'm trying to keep it in that purple safe zone as well. I'm gonna change to white. And a lot of these online editors don't have like an easy shadow option, but what you can do is copy your text and layer your text so that you have like maybe a shadow layer on underneath the actual text. So let's see, can I copy this? If I click this button, I think this means copy. Yay, there we go. And it's on top at the moment, but I can move it to the bottom. If I click this stack here, it's like a stack of papers. So if I click that and it opens up my layering options, and I can say move to the front or move to the back. I want to move that to the back. Hey presto, yay. Okay, let's do that. Maybe you want to say when you upload. If you upload at, you know, 7 p.m. on a Thursday, you want to put that in there, you can do that. Or you might want to give a little bit more information about the channel if it's not abundantly clear what it's your channel is about. I'm going to say that Billy Box Co. is bespoke boxes. Cool. Now, let's see what this looks like without that bottom layer showing through. So I'm going to click on my plant picture, and I'm going to click on the transparency and raise that transparency back up to see, is this easy to see? This is probably a little bit problematic. Maybe I can do something about that. I might put a rectangle shape underneath that bespoke boxes. Let's see what's in objects here. Cool. On Canva, I think it might be called something else, but it's, you need the shapes. Over here, I've got this square shape, and I'm gonna pop that in there. And I'm going to change the color of that one to white. And I'm also going to grab the top of it and lower that down so it gets little. Talking layers again, this is still a top layer, so I need to move it to the bottom. And I can do that by hitting the stack and move it to the back. There we go. Stack, move it to the back. Do, 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 do. So you might find as you're moving things around that they almost like snap into place as you're moving them. Hey, I think I'm pretty happy with that. Up here, up the top, and Canva has this as well. If you double click, you can rename your design. This is an SEO opportunity. You should name your banner what your channel is, and maybe you could even give a little bit more information. Like for me, my banner is something like Jess Bunty, that video girl. This one here, I'm making this channel Billy Box Co. So I'm just gonna name it Billy Box Co. Bespoke Boxes. Press enter, and then you can download it. All right, I'm gonna save it as PNG. PNG tends to be a higher, actually don't quote me on this. I think it's like a higher quality file format. And if you've been using transparencies, then you have to save things as PNG. I think it's the best way to go about it. So let's just do PNG. Hey presto, yay. Okay, we have made our banner, everybody. Well done to you. Give yourselves a pat on the back. Now you're gonna put it on your channel. You ready? Let's do this. Okay, so we're on our channel, right? It's blank. There is nothing here. We are gonna make it beautiful. So if you click customize channel, then you have another little wait. And this is what it might look like here. You want to add channel art. Click that button. Now you want to select a photo from your computer. So click that button. Then you need to find it in your downloads. Now, once that is fully uploaded to your channel, it's going to give you a few sort of mock-ups. It's going to tell you what it looks like on different devices. So if you want to adjust the crop, you can. You hit that button, but because you've used a template, it should be fine. So you just hit select and then ta-da! There you go. You're done. That's it. Give yourself a round of applause, a pat on the back, and a really strong cup of coffee. Good on you. I think that if you've gotten through this and you've conquered your fear of making some banner art, then you are bloody terrific, and I really do congratulate you. If you've got a question, let me know down below in the comments. What do you want to know when it comes to using video on social media or video on YouTube? Give this a like, tell your mate, tell your cat, tell people that this exists, and I really do look forward to catching you all next time. Have a fantastic rest of the day, everybody. See ya, bye.